Once again, now go to page number 170. Now, this is the special quality of Abdullah bin Umar. Write it down. Abdullah bin Umar himself said, I used to write everything that I heard from the Prophet, intending to commit it to memory. I spoke about it to the Prophet, who said, write down, for I speak only the truth, Abu Dawud. Then there is a supporting hadith of Abu Huraira. Next line, where Abu Huraira said, none of the companions preserved more traditions than myself, but Abdullah bin Amr is an exception, for he used to write and I did not. So Abu Huraira, he used to commit everything to his memory. This was his quality. He had a good memory. If you go back to page 169, and then in the middle of the second last paragraph, it says, Abu Huraira, who would remain in the Prophet's company at all times and store up in his memory everything that Prophet said or did. Alhamdulillah. Everybody clear? Underline this part here that Abu Huraira used to remain in the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, company at all times and store up in his memory everything that Prophet said or did. So this was the quality of Abu Huraira, that he used to store everything to his memory. Then Abdullah bin Amr, he used to write it down and then store it in his memory. So Abdullah bin Amr, because you know, when you write something down, then more things you will know. When you only commit it to memory, then fewer things you know as a human being. Then there's a third person, Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he used to write down. It's the next line. It says, Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu used to write down a hadith mainly concerned with the orders and instructions issued from time to time by Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. So his main concern was to concentrate, you know, different sahaba, they concentrated on different things. So this is the companion Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and he used to write down the instructions issued from time to time. Orders and instructions. See, everybody understand this point here, order and instructions. Order means, you know, like Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, ordered us to grow our beard and trim our mustache. This was the order of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So this is reported by Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And then people ask Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu that how long should be our mustache. So Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu replied that the top portion of your lips should be visible to everyone. This is how you trim your mustache. Up. Some people are shaving their mustache. If you shave your mustache, then you are again going against the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Because he says, trim your mustache. He did not say, shave your mustache. So, can you fix these people? No. Can you guide them? No. What you can do? Remind them. If you will know the hadith, then you will remind them. If you know the hadith, then you will say that my brother or my uncle or my chacha or my taya, the order of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, regarding mustache is you trim your mustache and grow your beard. Now there are so many people, unko choti choti si uldi si di, दाढ़ियां रखते हैं अजीबो गरीब, हो ताव दे दे के मूछे रखते हैं, वो रख रहे हैं, रखने दे, बट इट इज नॉट अकॉर्डिंग टू सुन्ना। एवरीबडी अंडरस्टैंड दिस इज नॉट अकॉर्डिंग टू दी सुन्ना। सो समबडी इज ग्रोइंग देयर, तो फिर क्या कर सकते हैं? एंड क्या होगा उनका? अल्लाह नोज बेटर, हु नोज अल्लाह, यू नो दैट व्हाई दे आर डूइंग इट, व्हाई दे फील दे लुक गुड रिजेम्बलिंग अ वुमेन, बिकॉज देयर इज अ ऑर्डर कि इफ द वुमेन ग्रोज अ स्टार्ट्स अ बियर्ड देन शी शुड शेव इट, बिकॉज ग्रोइंग अ बियर्ड इज नॉट अ फेमिनिन क्वालिटी, it is only for the men. So this is what orders, instructions mean. Pray as you have seen me pray. Pray as you have seen me pray. This is the order. ठीक है ना? So two orders I have told you. And then there are some sunnas. क्या sunnas है? How he used to walk, how he used to sleep, how he used to sit down, how he used to breathe. You know, things like this. Which people are doing, and this is the other kind of hadith about his personal life. Then let's come. Then two, Abdullah bin Amr and Abdullah bin Abbas. They wrote a book called Sadiqa, which is supposed to be a book of hadith. Underline it. Everybody underline it. Abdullah bin Amr and Abdullah bin Abbas wrote a book called Sadqa. This compilation of Abdullah bin Umar was known as Sadqa. So this is the name of a book of Hadith. Early book of Hadith. See, earlier these books were all, you know, mixed up. That they were just hadith, 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 very difficult to read. As we will read later on, then Imam Malik and you know, Abu Bukhari, Rahmatullah Alayh, and Imam Muslim, they came and they organized the hadith. Now, once they organized the hadith, then it became easier for us to read them also and to understand them also. Because first it was a compilation of hadith, there was just hadith, 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 hadith. So then it was very difficult to relate to another hadith from the first hadith. But what these new generation people, they were also, you know, taba tabain, or the people they have seen taba tabain. When they compiled the books, they divided it into chapters. So there is a chapter on namaz, there is a chapter on ibadat, there is a chapter on zikr. They call them bab, bab ibadat. बाब ईमान, ठीक है ना, बाब रमजान, बाब शब कदर, बाब कबर, बाब हशर, बाब अंजाम, बाब जन्नत, और पता नहीं कौन कौन से बाब। व्हाट दिस डज इज देन इट बिकेम इजियर फॉर अस, इफ आई वांट टू रीड अबाउट दी जन्ना आल्सो, सो आई विल ओपन दैट बाब एंड रीड अबाउट दैट and read about it. Earlier with these earlier books, if you wanted to find a hadith about the Jannah, then you have to read the whole book to find the hadith. Achha, be very careful about the net also. It gives all kind of fake news also and fake information also. You have to be very, very careful about the net. Do not, I am advising you, do not learn from the internet Islam. First, if you still want to learn from the, you know, then listen to your teachers, like listen to Mufti Tariq Masood. He's a renowned scholar, current scholar. He talks about the current problems also. Sheikh Nazir, Bilal Phillips, Brother Siraj. These are authentic people. Then Mufti Maniki. And there is another mufti, it comes from Al Huda. I think it is Al Huda from Dubai. So there are so many different kind of ahadith, and you have to listen to the correct source. Try to listen to it from the correct source. Now come to the quality of Aisha رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ, because Aisha رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ was the youngest wife of Prophet Muhammad peace be upon him, and she spent a time, very quality time with Prophet Muhammad peace be upon him, and she wrote many ahadith, and she wrote many ahadith, and her hafza, her memorization was excellent, and her one of her best quality was this, that she used to get it written here. It is 1, 2, 3, 3rd, 4th paragraph. Aisha رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ, the Prophet Muhammad peace be upon him wife, had an excellent memory, by virtue of which she used to preserve the saying of the Prophet. And then she used to refuse to accept anything until she was fully satisfied to its meaning. Ye key words hai. She refused to accept anything until she was fully satisfied as to its meaning. देखिए इस हदीस को, इस बात को समझे कि आयशा रजी अल्लाह ताला ने उन हदीस को जमा किया और फिर हदीस को जो अपने जहन में रखा और सिर्फ उस बात को रखा जिससे वो पूरी तरीके से मुतमईन हो, और पूरी तरीके से मुतमईन कैसे हुई, she asked Prophet Muhammad peace be upon him questions after questions after questions, and this is how she preserved the high quality ahadith. So Aisha رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ, this was her best quality. Then third, another last point from this section is that Umar رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ, he used to live slightly away from the Masjid Nabi. So he used to come on alternate days, and he had his one of his friend, who was his friend. Well, the neighbor lived in Medina, so he made a, you know, kind of a friendship treaty with his friend that one day he will stay in the company of Prophet Muhammad peace be upon him, and one day I will stay in the company of the Prophet Muhammad peace be upon him, and then we will share our information that what we learned. Underline, done. Everybody, okay. Any questions so far? Any word meaning you don't understand from this section? कोई सवाल हो जो आप समझना चाहते हो अभी जो हमने पढ़ा है इसमें से? एनी क्वेश्चन? एनी वन हैज एनी वर्ड मीनिंग्स? Alright, Kissa, then read collection and compilation after the death of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him.
Okay, sir. Collection and compilation after the Prophet's peace be upon him death. Soon after the death of the Prophet, peace be upon him, the need for some authoritative guidance in Quranic interpretation was felt. The need was felt all the more because of religious and political divisions. All because the expulsions now from a small community to a mighty empire created all kinds of political, economic, legal, and social problems quite unknown during the days of the Prophet, peace be upon him. When Islam has spread widely, new converts wanted to hear about the Prophet, peace be upon him, from his close companions and associates. These people were the best authority for a knowledge of Ahadith and Sunnah, as they had listened to the Prophet, peace be upon him, and witnessed his actions. They become a source of knowledge for later converts, and since the incidents were fresh in their memory, they could be conveyed with fair accuracy to the new generation. Every one of them who had the slightest knowledge of any incident relating to the Prophet, peace be upon him, life, deemed it his duty to deliver it to another. Individuals like Abu Huraira, Abdul bin Abbas, Abdul bin Umar, Anas bin Malik, and many others became the centers to whom people resorted from different parts of Islamic empire to gain knowledge about the Prophet, peace be upon him. The Prophet,
all right,
peace be upon him, wives were...
Thank you, Kissa. Thinking first, there was only one source of knowledge available to the companions, that was Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So after his demise, after his death, when he was no longer on earth, people, because Islam was expanding and then it was conquering new and new places, were being conquered, taken from the Jews and the Christians. There was a need. People are asking new questions. Then there were some corrupt people also. Then they started misguiding the people. So what happened, that these big scholars, then they started having their own classes of dars. And for example, here Abu Huraira, Abdullah bin Abbas, Abdullah bin Umar, Anas bin Malik. So all these people, they started there, and there were others also. And from these classes, then people learned about the Ahadith and about the lifestyle of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Hamna, let's read page 71, first paragraph. Yes, Hamna Sajjad, let's read first paragraph. All right, Aliza Adil, let's read first paragraph, page 171, the Prophet's wife.
Upon him were also looked upon as vital custodians of Ahadith and were approached for instruction by other companions. The names of Aisha radhiyallahu ta'ala anha, Hafsa radhiyallahu ta'ala anha, Umme Habiba radhiyallahu ta'ala anha.
These all anha. Okay, these are ladies. Aliza, stop. You know, these are all ladies, Azwaj-e Muhtarat. So whenever the ladies be sahabiya, we say anha. And for sahabi, we say anho. Okay. So read their names again one more time. Okay, Aisha radhiyallahu ta'ala anha.
The names of Aisha radhiyallahu ta'ala anha, Hafsa radhiyallahu ta'ala anha, Umme Habiba radhiyallahu ta'ala anha, Maimuna radhiyallahu ta'ala anha, and Umme Salma radhiyallahu ta'ala anha are among the earliest and most distinguished transmitters. In particular, Aisha radhiyallahu ta'ala is one of the most important figures in history of these literature, not only as one of the earliest reporters of the largest number of hadith, but as one most careful interpreters of hadith. Some of the companions settled in different towns in the various provinces where they were surrounded by a large number of Muslims who were eager to hear reports and deeds. It is reported that such as large crowd of them collected around a companion when he related a hadith, that he would climb the roof of a nearby house so that he could be heard. With the passing away of the companions, there were no more reports to be investigated from different persons. The ahadith became the property of teachers who taught at various centers. They were known as the successors of the companions.
All right,
at this
stop.
stage,
Thank
the writing
you.
Of ahadith.
See here, they are talking about the three generations, okay? The first generation are the companions. Okay, everybody knows Sahaba. Second generation is successors of the companions. And the third generation was the successors of the successors. So companions, successors of the companions, and the third one is successors of the successors. So first one Sahaba, then Tabaeen, and then Taba Tabaeen. Everybody underline it, the three generations. Okay, now we're going to go to the next generation. These were basically now, these are the Muhaddaseen, the people who wrote down the Ahadith. And we're going to read about the Muhaddaseen. Now there was one word, interpreters of Ahadith. Interpreters in the first paragraph, last, second last word, interpreters. Meaning people who explain something. People who give up explanation of something. People who give an explanation of something. Now we are going to read about these books of Ahadith and who wrote them. All right. So let's see. Yusra, let's read. In those days, page 171.
In those days, to recite and memorize the Hadith was considered to be a great privilege, since they were preserved in writing as well. In due course of time, a great amount of Ahadith literature was collected. The most authoritative and the first collection of Ahadith was Al-Muwatta, compiled by Imam Malik bin 94,000 is that of Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, 164 AH, founder of the Hanbali school of law. Up to the beginning of the 3rd century of Islam, compilations of Ahadith did not discriminate between authentic Ahadith and other less than authentic, so the Ahadith were mixed up. Imam Muhammad ibn Ismail al-Bukhari, 194 till 256 AH, was the first to conceive the idea of compiling the authentic Ahadith. On account of the strict conditions he laid down for accepting Ahadith, he called his compilation Sahih, that is the authentic compilation. It is said that he used to seek aid in prayer before recording any Hadith. He devoted about 16 years of his life to the compilation of his Sahih, which is generally considered by the Muslims as an authority second only to the Quran.
Underline from this part here. The Sahih Bukhari, his Sahih, which is generally considered by the Muslim as an authentic authority second only to the Quran. Okay, second only. Emphasize on this part, second only. Okay, so even if in Bukhari also written by Imam Muhammad ibn Ismail al-Bukhari, and he was born in 194 and 256 AH. Again, since he was born in 194, so it means that he had seen, at least he must have seen the successors of the successors, Tabatabain. And if you go up, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, he was born in 164 AH. AH means after Hijri. This is the Hijri calendar. 164 AH. So there is a big chance that he also saw Tabain or the Taba Tabain. Now Imam Malik bin Anas was a confirmed Tabain. Imam Malik bin Anas was born in 94 AH. Underline it. So he was a Tabain, successor of a companion. He was not a companion of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, but he had seen the companions of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Now let's go to the next page. On the next page, continue, Yusra.
From a very young age, Imam Bukhari immersed himself in the study of Hadith, and within 6 years, he had mastered all the traditions of Bukhara as well as everything contained in the books which were available to him. He then traveled to Makkah, from where he started a series of journeys in search of Muslims who could recite a Hadith to him in all the important centers of Islamic learning. He is said to have questioned more than 1,000 masters of Hadith who lived in far off places. He was recognized as the greatest traditionist of his time by all the major authorities with whom he came into contact. Imam Bukhari sifted through all the traditions known to him, selected about 73,907 out of some 6 lakh ahadith and arranged them according to their
7,397 out of 6 lakh ahadith.
7,397 out of 6 lakh ahadith and arranged them according to their subject matter under separate headings, most of which are taken from the Quran and in some cases from the traditions themselves. The ahadith in the Sahih are compiled into 97 books according to the teachings they contain. The first book is called the Start of Revelation to the Messenger of Allah. The last book is called Tawheed, Divine Unity. There are books devoted to ablution, the various kinds of prayer, zakat, pilgrimage, books on agriculture, business transactions, types of gas, medicine, and many more matters. There are teachings about the practices that the Prophet, peace be upon him, had witnessed in the markets of Mecca and Medina. The practice of selling goods at an inflated price and the curse of usury. An easy source of guidance. Imam Bukhari's main object was to collect together the sound traditions only. By these, he meant such traditions as were handed down to him from the Prophet, peace be upon him, through a continuous chain of reliable narrators who had actually met each other. Known for their integrity, possessed of a good memory, and firm faith. On the condition that their narrations were not contrary to what was related by other reliable authorities and were free from defect.
All right, thank you, Yusra. See, as I was telling you about the Bab, you know that Bab is means here again also they have called it books. Okay, another place they have called them chapters also. So books also same thing as chapters. There are sections. Inshallah, Monday everybody is coming to school. Two? No, 8, 9, 10 will come inshallah from Monday. We will send you a circular also. Okay, 8, 9, 10 will come from Monday. So 8, 9, 10 will come from Monday and then we will I will show you the books also, and I will give you physically the books in your hands of these hadith. Why? Because many homes, they don't have these books, and many homes, they have no books. Now this is, if you want to give something, you know, in jahiz to your child, my concentration is going to be that give them good books of ahadith like Sahih Bukhari, Sahih Muslim, and give them the Quran. And in our school, we give them, when the child completes their inter and matric, from they come and they collect their certificate. So I give them Fatawa bin Baz. He's a Mufti from Saudi Arabia, and he has wrote about more than 300 some difficulties that problem face, people face in different part of their life. So these are, he was a Abdul Aziz was a, you know, Grand Mufti. Grand Mufti means the biggest Mufti of Saudi Arabia. So inshallah, we hope that he is guiding to the right path, and inshallah, we hope that by reading his books also you come to the right path. But even with him also, even with Abdul Aziz bin Baz, you have to still have the knowledge of the Quran first. This is why I selected this Quran, because when I went for Hajj, you know, in 2002, Hajj was in, I think it was in February. Okay, in 2002, Hajj was in February. So I was there in Makkah and Medina, and I performed the Hajj in Makkah. So I read this translation of the Quran, and this was very easily readable. This is why I came back to Pakistan and started people that start reading this Quran. I brought, see, our cable is jumping. This is why it had disappeared. Now it is again here. So mashallah, we have good collection today of students here. Okay. Hajra is here. Abdullah Atta Ansari is here. Aisha, Aliza, Aksa, Amna, Kissa, Muhammad Ali Ghori, Sheikh Sohail, Yusra. See, when you will come to your classes regularly, this is how you're going to learn the most. Even if you just sit and listen, even then you are learning. The people who are sitting, sir, sleeping at home, yes, go ahead.
सर मंडे को जो है 8, 9 और 10 आएंगे, हमने कब आना पड़ेगा
बेटा? अभी तो हम यही कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि 8, 9, 10 सब आए, तीनों आएंगे 8, 9 और 10. तो आप सोहेल 8 में है ना, तो आप भी इंशाल्लाह मंडे को आएंगे. अगर उसके बीच में कोई और खबर आई तो फिर आपको बताएंगे हम, लेकिन हम जो है 8, 9, 10 को बुला रहे हैं. ठीक है, so everybody has to come 8, 9 and 10, unless the government decides, because there is another meeting on the 15th. Government has another meeting on the 15th. So inshallah, by Saturday we will send you, inform you. Okay, we will inform everybody. We have, I think, less than a minute left of the recording time. Any other words and word meaning that you want to ask me? Okay, let's read the last paragraph. Okay, I'm going to read and I want you to underline. Imam Bukhari's main object was to collect together the sound traditions only. By this, he meant such traditions which were handed down to him from Prophet. Number one, देखिए, handed down from Prophet. Number one यहाँ से आया, handed down टू हिम फ्रॉम द प्रॉफिट थ्रू अ कंटिन्यूस चेन ऑफ रिलायबल नरेटर्स. नंबर वन. नंबर टू, हु हैड एक्चुअली मेट ईच अदर. देखिए दिस इज कंपल्सरी कि जो है दे शुड हैव मेट ईच अदर. दिस इज वाई रेफरेंस इज एक्सट्रीमली इम्पोर्टेंट. एक साहब ने नेट के ऊपर एक सूरत डाली. मैंने उनसे ये पूछा कि जो है ये बरेलवी साहब थे, काफी दिनों के बाद पकड़े गए. मैंने कहा ये आपने ये आयत ली कहां से. उन्होंने पहले तो मुझे जवाब नहीं दिया, फिर बहुत दिन के बाद जवाब दिया. तो उन्होंने फिर ये चैप्टर नंबर और वर्स नंबर मुझे लिख के भेजा कि ये इसमें से. तो मैंने उसको ये चेक किया तो उस सूरत के अंदर जो है उसका वर्स नंबर अगर मुझे याद है शायद 41 था. वर्स नंबर 41 था ही नहीं क्योंकि जो है 40 के ऊपर सूरत खत्म हो गई. मैंने उनको फिर वापस भेजा कि आपने ये गलत दिया है और ऐसा रेफरेंस दिया है जिस रेफरेंस के अंदर जो है आपका सूरत नंबर और जो है आयत नंबर ही गलत है. आयत नंबर ही गलत है, इतनी आयतें ही नहीं है उसके अंदर. फिर वो साहब गायब हो गए. फिर थोड़े दिन के बाद फिर आए, मैंने फिर पकड़ लिया उनको. तो उसके बाद उन्होंने कहा अरे कुछ हो गया होगा, गलती हो गई होगी, आप देख लीजिए. ठीक है ना. देखिए दिस इज हाउ पीपल कंफ्यूज अदर पीपल. एक चीज कुरान में जिस तरीके से है, जब भी आप रेफरेंस कोट करें उसको करेक्टली एक्यूरेटली कोट करें, इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. तो ये जो बुखारी की बात है ना कि ये हैंडेड डाउन कंटिन्यूसली फ्रॉम रिलायबल चेन ऑफ रेफरेंस, ये एक बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट बात है कि जो है किस शख्स ने वो बात कन्वे की. तो इसलिए जो है हमें जो चीज़ों के ऊपर बहुत सख्त ख्याल रखना चाहिए. एंड वी शुड बी वेरी एक्सट्रीमली केयरफुल. और ये नाम ज़रूर याद करें कि दिस हदीस केम फ्रॉम बुखारी और मुस्लिम और तिर्मिज़ी. ये आपका सेफ गार्ड भी है, एक शील्ड है आपके लिए. किस तरह से शील्ड है कि आपने ये हदीस बुखारी के अंदर पढ़ी थी, आपने फिर उस हदीस को आगे बढ़ाया और बताया कि बुखारी में ही थी. तो किसी वक्त अगर ये कुछ किसी को महसूस होता है कि ये गलत है या इट इज़ इनकरेक्ट या उसके अंदर कोई कमी लगती है तो जाके उसको